mighty name of Christ Jesus, I bless all of you. Today is July 8th and this is the 189th drop of the living water. We are learning step by step, word by word, his prayer. The Lord Jesus taught his disciples how to pray. He gave them an exemplary prayer. So we are learning that. Digging deep into that prayer. Couple of verses, but we need to dig deep because we need to understand the depth of those words. By now we learn four words actually. Our Father in heaven. Our means you and I, we all are his children. So we must reconcile, we must reconnected, we must love each other, because no matter what, who he is, she is, he is a child of God. So do I. So we must correct our relationship first. If not, we are not allowed to call him Father. Why? He is his Father as well as my Father. So horizontal relationship in between man and man must be corrected. Then only we can think of the vertical relationship with man and God. If first one horizontal is broken, no way the vertical one is already broken. We cannot rebuild this vertical relationship with man and God if the horizontal relationship is already broken. Our Father. And as he is our Father, we must obey him. We must listen to him. We must surrender ourselves. Our Father in heaven means he lives. That is simple present tense. Look at the tense in this verse. It says, our Father who art in heaven. Who lives in heaven means it is not in the past tense who lived in. No. Who is gonna live? No. It is simple present tense, means that is forever. That is forever. He lives in heaven. He is living God. He is alive and forever and ever. He was, is and will. So all time. He is the Lord God. He is living. That is why our Father in heaven. If he lives in heaven means he is the authorized God, God of gods, Lord of lords, King of kings. And we must surrender ourselves, obey him, listen to him and follow him according to the word of God. Got it? Right. So let's move on. The next word, it says, we are still in verse 9. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. What does that mean? Glory be to your name. Praise be to your name. Honor your name. That's the meaning. Hallowed. So first we need to understand, acknowledge what his name is. His name is Jesus. The Lord Jesus. Christ Jesus. Jesus is the name. But our relationship to him is father-son, father-child relationship. He is our Father. We are his children. So let me ask you a question. Have we ever called to our earthly father by his name? No way. We have never talked to him by his name. We call him Father, Daddy, Dad, Appachi, Papa. So we call him with respect. We never use his name to call him, address him. No, never, never. What about the Father, Heavenly Father? How do we talk to him? How do we address him? We just ignore all this divinity and respect, but we disrespect his name. How we call him? Jesus. Just like Kamal, Sunil, Martin, Gregory, Jesus. What is this? Just think of this. This is how we call him. This is how we address him to our Heavenly Father. Is this reasonable? Is this fair? And also, we must acknowledge His divinity, and He is the Lord of Lords. Do we respect Him, honor Him, or do we use His name for always, like in vain? Have we think of this? Think of the places that, even in hymns, even when we singing, we say that, okay, we praise and worship, but we disrespect using His name in vain. So, my children, instead of respecting, we disrespect. Instead of honoring, we dishonor Him. So, we are breaking the third commandment. Do not use His name in vain. Are we there? So, we have to think of all these things and to be corrected. May the Lord God bless you and keep you. See you tomorrow.